Okay, let's go ahead and start walking in our space, walking in the space that you have, walking in place. Just tune into your body. Take note of anything that feels especially tight today. And stretch it out a little extra as we go through. All right, go ahead and do arm circles, starting small circles, rolling those arms forward and getting bigger as we go. Working through your full range of motion.
Hey, Tara.
Yes.
I can't figure out how to mute myself. So, do you just want to mute me? I don't know if I have a lot of background noise or not for
Yeah,
you.
I can mute you. And for reference, it's either #6 or *6 to mute unmute on dial-in.
Star six.
*6.
Star six on the cell phone.
Yep, but I'll mute you.
Thank you.
Of course. All right. Go ahead, roll your arms backwards this time. Smaller, working through your range of motion, getting bigger as you go.
I had fun skiing this last weekend.
I know, I heard.
Lots of fresh powder. 6 inches while we were up there.
Oh, wow. That's crazy. Let's go into glute kicks next, kicking your heel back to your bottom. So snow over there too, but I hear it's melting today.
Yes, it's fastly melting. It's got big old raindrops outside.
Lots of mixed weather. Let's trade these glute kicks out for high knees. Get those knees up nice and high, pushing out the backs of our legs or hamstrings. Heart rates are rising, bodies are warm. If you haven't already, get those arms moving in opposition. All right, shake that out. Windmill toe touches. Here we go. Feet wider than shoulder width apart, toes point forward. Opposite hand reaches towards opposite foot. Bending down the waist, core stretch. Inner thigh stretch, back of the leg stretch. Getting it all warmed up. All right. Go ahead, shake that out. Let's go to calf raises or heel raises. Heels go up, heels go down. Taking nice deep breaths. Getting ready for our first circuit. Okay, go ahead, shake out anything else that you need. Let's break down our circuit one exercises. Our first exercise is for our upper body and back. It's an upright row. So you'll stand in an upright position, a soft bend to your knees, and then you might have a tiny hinge forward. So maybe shoulders are just an inch or so in front of your hips. Arms are down. Palms face your thighs, so they're in front of you. Then, if you have weights, great. Hold on to them. If you don't, just put your hands in fists. And then you're going to bend your elbows so that your left elbow comes up, points left, right elbow comes up, points right. And they're just beneath your shoulder level. So your fists end up kind of by your collarbone. And then you'll drop your arms back down. So that is an upright row. Palms face you, elbows bend and rise to shoulder height or just below, and then lower. Your arms, your palms face your thighs, and then they stay in that position as they go up your body. So your arms aren't getting wider or narrower. They're staying in that straight line as they travel upwards towards your collarbone. Any questions about
Wait a minute.
upright?
I thought a row was out in front of you and came towards you.
So that is a variation of a row. That's a standard row. We're doing an upright row.
So can you explain that one more time because I was confused.
So standing comfortable position, put your hands, your palms on your thighs, on the front of your thighs. And if you want to hold weights, you're holding weights. Our hands are in fists now. Bend your elbows to rise to shoulder height, left elbow points left, right elbow points right, hands come
Oh, I
towards
get it.
your collarbone. So it's
I
kind
get
of
it.
like
Oh my
coming
God.
up to your chicken wings and then lowering it.
Right, I get it now. Sorry, I was confused.
Yeah, no worries. Are there any other questions about our upright rows? Okay. Next up is for thighs and glutes. We're doing a shuffle squat. So get into your squat position, sit in your imaginary chair. Hands can go in a prayer on your hips or out to your sides, whatever makes you most successful. And you're gonna shuffle to one side. So right foot steps right, left foot follows. And then once you get to the end of your space, you're gonna deepen your squat and raise up a little bit and stay low, shuffle to the left. Finish with a squat before you keep going. Any questions about shuffle squat? Okay. Next up for our core and our obliques is our standing side crunch. So if you want to have weights in your hands, you can and have your hands by your sides, or you can put your hands behind head with elbows pointed wide if you don't have weights. Then you're going to crunch to the right. So, right ear points down towards the right, come back up, left ear points down to the left. So, you're shrinking those abs on the side and elongating on the other side. So, it's a side-to-side motion. Any questions about our standing side crunches? Okay, cardio is high knees or whatever you choose for our high knees. Or for a cardio exercise, just get your heart rates up. Okay, without further ado, let's get started. I'm gonna start our timer. Playing our tunes. If it's too loud, let me know. 3, 2, 1, upright rows. Hands in front of your thighs, bend those elbows to point left and right, just beneath shoulder height, and lower them back down. You can have a tiny hinge forward. That helps you protect your back. Job. Squeeze your shoulder blades together at the top. 3, 2, 1. Rest. Next up is our shuffle squat. 3, 2, 1. Exercise. Go ahead, get down nice and low. Shuffle to the side, then get deeper in your squat before you switch shuffling in the other direction. We've got some 80s hits playing today. When you're squatting down, keep those knees tracked over your ankle. Nice job. Belly button pulled to spine. 3, 2, 1. Rest. Next up, our standing side crunch. So either weights in your hands by your sides, or no weights, hands behind head, elbows wide. 3, 2, 1, exercise. So you're moving side to side. So if your hands are behind your head, right elbow points down, come back up, left elbow points down. Nice job. If you want to add a lateral high knee, the right knee goes up laterally as you crunch to the right. That's an extra challenge. 3, 2, 1. We're resting. Next up is our cardio, high knees. 3, 2, 1. Exercise, high knees or cardio of your choice. Get your heart rate up. Nice job. You are doing these high knees. Get those knees up as high as you can. Don't cheat yourself out of it. Nice job. Stick through. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice job. Taking it to the top with our upright rows next. 3, 2, 1. Here we go, upright rows. Hands, palms face your thighs in front. Bend those elbows. Give yourself chicken wings, right elbow points right, left elbow points left. Elbows come up just below shoulder height before you drop your arms back down and repeat. Upper body and back strengthening. Three, two, one, rest. Next up is our shuffle squat. Catch your breath. Three, two, one, here we go, shuffle squat. Bend your knees, get low, athletic stance. Shuffle to one side, add a deep squat, stay low. Shuffle to the other side. Belly button pulled the spine so that your back is nice and strong, nice and flat. Knees track over ankles to keep the work in your hamstrings, your glutes, and your thighs, and not the knee joint. Three, two, one, rest. Nice job. Next up, standing side crunches. Three, two, one, exercise. Here we go. If you don't have weights, hands go behind your head, elbows point wide. Bending to point one elbow down towards the ground. Coming back up, other elbow towards the ground. If you have weights, hands by your sides. Option to add that lateral high knee if you don't have weights to make it more challenging, less stability going on. Three, two, one, rest. Next up is our cardio. Once again, high knees or a movement to get your heart rate up, your choice. Three, two, one, exercise. I'm doing high knees. Heart rates are up. Nice job. You've got this. Heart rate's high, knees high, deep breaths, three, two, one, rest. Nice job, one more set through circuit number one. We start with upright rows in three, two, one, here we go. Palms face your thighs, hands and fists, bend those elbows out to left and right. Stopping just before shoulder height, dropping down and repeating. Hands go from thighs straight up to collarbone. Three, two, one, rest. Nice job, those are done. Next exercise is shuffle squat. Last time doing these. Three, two, one, here we go. Bend those knees, shuffle to one side, add that extra squat before you shuffle in the other direction. Belly button pulled in strong. Working our thighs, glutes, and hamstrings here. Job. How low can you go? Three, two, one, rest. Nice job, that those are done. Next exercise, standing side crunches, working on our obliques. Three, two, one, here we go. Hands behind head, elbows wide. Side crunch, side to side movement. Right elbow points down as the right side of the body crunches to shrink and the left side elongates. Repeat on the other side. Again, option to add that lateral high knee if you don't have weight to decrease stability. Belly button pulled the spine. Three, two, one, rest. One more exercise of circuit one is our cardio. High knees or cardio of your choice. Three, two, one, here we go. High knees. Nice job. Get those knees up nice and high. Nice deep breaths. Heart rates are up. Three, two, one. Beautiful. Nice job, everybody. Take your rest. Pause the tunes, get a drink, do what you gotta do. We move on to secret circuit number two. Little Dr. Seuss action there. Okay. Circuit two. Oh, goodness. Okay. First exercise is for our triceps, the backs of our arms. So we're doing diamond push-ups. So these can go on a wall, on your knees, or on your toes for our diamond push-ups. Same as a standard push-up. The only thing that's different is our hand placement. So put your hands on the ground, and they're called diamond push-ups because between your big or your pointer fingers is what I'm trying to say, and your thumbs, you're going to make a diamond. So pointer fingers touch and thumbs touch right beneath your chest. And then that means when you bend your elbows, they're going to a tighter diagonal, hugging closer to your body, which means the triceps, the back of the arms, are more activated. Any questions about our diamond push-ups? Okay. I think that everyone's gonna hate me after this circuit, but it's okay. I'm doing it too. Just remember that. Okay, next exercise is wall sits. So, working on our thighs here. So, for a wall sit, you are gonna sit in an imaginary chair, find a wall or something sturdy, and rest your back on it. That is our thighs. So, when you are doing your wall sit, entire back as high as you can, pushed into the wall, and then knees directly over ankles. The lower your bum is in line with your knees, the more it's gonna hurt, the more it's gonna burn. Any questions about wall sits? Okay. Now, our core exercise, our obliques and lower bonus lower body exercise, is a lunge to a standing crunch. So left foot steps forward and right foot is back. Bend both knees to 90 degrees so you're lunged. And then hands behind head, elbows wide. You're gonna stand up, do a right high knee. So my right knee was in back. It's gonna do a high knee, and then I'm gonna twist to have my chest face right. Step down, reset, right foot in front, left foot in back. Bend to lunge, left knee comes up, and do my twist. If that is a lot of balance and you find yourself wobbling, you can hold on to something for balance, or you can do your lunge, twist towards the leg that's in front, come up out of the lunge, repeat, twist towards the leg that's in front, instead of doing that high knee as you twist. So those are some options. Those are our lunge crunches. Does anyone have any questions about those?
So if our left leg comes up forward first, then we lunge, we come up with up and then high knee, or you stay down low in the lunge and try to do a high knee and then fall over.
So as I come up
Okay.
to standing, my right knee does a
Okay,
high knee. So it's all
I
one
just thought.
fluid motion. Then I'll do my
Okay,
little
I just.
crunch and reset.
Yeah, I get that. Okay, thanks.
Okay. Awesome. Okay. Any other questions about our lunge crunch? Okay. And then just for my dear friend Trisha, our cardio exercise is the inchworms. Love you all. Hate me later. Okay. So inchworms, you're going to reach down for a forward fold, walk your hands out to a plank, optional push-up once you get there, walk your hands back, and stand up nice and tall, hands to the ceiling. Now, this is your cardio exercise. So if you're like, no way in heck I'm doing inchworms for fun, just do something that raises your heart rate. You do not have to do inchworms. Any questions about inchworms? Okay, perfect. Okay. Let's get to it. Circuit number two, starting my timer. Starting with our diamond push-ups. Goodness gracious. Just remember, I'm doing this too, so I have the same emotions, okay? Play, play. Three, two, one. Diamond push-ups. So hands, pointer fingers together, thumbs apart. Do your push-ups. Working on those triceps, backs of the arms. Option to do these on your knees or against a wall. You got it. Straight line from head to heels, so your belly button's pulled into your spine. Don't dip your hips or pike them up. Keep it nice and flat. 3, 2, 1, rest. Wonderful. We get ready for our wall sit. 3, 2, 1, exercise. So sit in your imaginary chair. Back is pressed against the wall. Sink your bottom down towards knee level. Ankles right beneath knees. Take deep breaths. These are our thighs working here. I gotta tell you guys, I printed off this workout, and as soon as I printed it off, I looked at it and I go, what the heck was I thinking when I made this? 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job. Next up is our lunge crunches. 3, 2, 1, exercise. So 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. Come up to your high knee, do your crunch, then switch it out. So, twisting. Woo! To add that oblique work at the top. You've got it. 90 degree bend in both knees. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job. Next up is our inchworms. 3, 2, 1, exercise. Reach down, walk your hands out. Optional push up at the bottom. Walk your hands back, raise your hands. If you want to take it to a burpee, add the jump at the top. If you want to do different cardio, I don't blame you. You got this. Woo. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job, everybody. We start back out with our diamond push-ups next. Knees, wall, or toes. 3, 2, 1, diamond push-ups, here we go. Point your fingers together and thumbs together underneath your chest. Found yourself here. Back stays flat. Belly button pulled the spine. Triceps on fire. Nice job. Woo! 3, 2, 1, rest. We did it. Next up, wall sit. 3, 2, 1, exercise. So sit in your imaginary chair, back pushed up against a wall, knees bent to 90 degrees, knees track over ankles, hips down to knee height. If you're looking for an extra challenge, you can go onto your tippy toes here, or you can put weights on your thighs. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job.
I don't see how you do this next one.
The lunge crunch?
Yeah.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. All right. Lunge crunch. Left foot steps forward, right foot steps back into your lunge. As you stand up, right knee comes to high knee. Twist chest to right. Foot down, reset. Opposite foot steps back this time. Left foot steps back. Then after your lunge, left foot high knees. Twist to left, reset. The big balance challenge. So if you choose, take out the high knee and just do the twist. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up is inchworms. Was that better, Jeanette?
No.
3, 2.
I'll have to work on it. I can't ever figure out which way to turn.
Inchworms. Okay. Do your cardio. When you're turning towards your high knee. If you're not doing a high knee, you're turning towards your front leg.
Okay.
Keep moving. Three, two, one, rest. Nice job, everybody. One more round of circuit two. Coming live. starting with our diamond push-ups in 3, 2, 1. Triceps on fire. Pointer fingers together, thumbs together underneath the chest. Bend the elbows back. Tricep activation. Down. 3, 2, 1. Rest. Nice job. Next up, wall sit. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Back against the wall, imaginary chair. Knees over ankles, hips down to knee height. Challenge to add weights to your lap. Lift up to your tippy toes. But sticking here is just fine, it's hard enough. Three, two, one, rest. Next up is our lunge to crunch. 3, 2, 1, exercise. Both knees bend. Option to twist before you come up or twist towards your high knee. So if you add the high knee, twist towards your knee. If you do not add the high knee, twist towards your front leg. Deep breaths, lots of balance work. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job. Done and done. Last one of circuit 2 is our inchworms or cardio of your choice. 3, 2, 1, exercise. You're doing your inchworms, walk your hands out to your plank, optional push-up, walk your hands back, optional jump when you get to the top. Or just keep moving, cardio of your choice. Get your heart rate up. Nice job. 3, 2, 1. Rest. Nice job. We did it.
I'll reset. That gave me flashbacks of high school volleyball practice.
Oh, you're welcome. Hopefully they're good flashbacks. Oh, okay. I just got water so that I can continue to live as we go through this. Okay, circuit 3, we are doing biceps first. Bicep curl to shoulder press. So hands by your sides, palms face forward, fingertips down. Option to hold weights or put your hands and fists here without weights. Bicep curl, so your elbows bend, so your fists now face your shoulders. Then we add the shoulder press. So elbows are gonna then point out to either side and you're gonna twist your palms to now face forward. Raise the roof, hands go to the sky, and then you reverse that. Bend those elbows, palms are still forward. Then you turn your palms to face you, elbows in front of shoulders, release arms back down towards your thighs. Any questions about bicep curl to shoulder press? Okay.
We're pushing up.
Oh, go ahead, Crystal.
We're pushing up or out?
Up.
Out, away from us, or out,
yep,
above us?
Bicep curl is up, and then your elbows go wide, palms face forward, and then you push up, raise the roof. Does that sound okay?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Okay, next exercise is focused on glutes. So we'll do a glute, standing glute kickback. So I might need to hold on to like a wall for balance here, but you'll hold on to your wall for balance, right heel to your bottom. So you're standing tall on your left leg, and then you have like a glute kick on your right side. Instead of releasing that glute kick, you're gonna push your heel, kick your heel backward. Maybe it's just an inch, and then release. And then we'll switch sides. Left heel kicks back, release. Switch sides. Standing nice and tall, shoulders stacked over hips. Any questions about glute kickbacks?
So where does your foot go after you've done your glute kick?
After you kick, you just switch feet. So you just bounce on that other leg.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Okay. All right. Then next exercise is for shoulders. So palms down on your thighs. Palms face you, fingertips down. Raise your arms to shoulder height in front of you. And then lower them back down. So arms stay straight the whole time. Arms, palms touch your thighs. And then the backs of your hands face the ceiling. Arms at shoulder height. Option to hold weights for this. Any questions about front arm raises? Okay. Then we have cardio, your choice. I'll be doing glute kicks. Any questions about any of those before we get rolling? Okay. Here we go. I'm going to hit play, play, and we go. 3, 2, 1, bicep curl to shoulder press. So palms face away from you, bend your elbows, curl your palms towards your shoulders, then elbows wide, raise the roof. Sounds like this is a slip song to me. Here we go. Nice job, everybody. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up is our standing glute kickback. So hold on to something for balance if you need. 3, 2, 1. So your right heel comes to your bottom. Kick your heel back nice and sharp, keeping that bend in your knee. Leg comes down, repeat on the other side. Continue alternating. Try to keep your knees in line and push your kicking knee backwards. Working those glutes. 3, 2, 1, press. Nice job. Next up, front arm raises, strengthening our shoulders. 3, 2, 1, exercise. Palms face you, touching your thighs. They raise up like a zombie, like Frankenstein, and then lower back down. What I actually realized is that it's not Frankenstein that has his arms out, that the monster is not called Frankenstein, it's the doctor that's called Frankenstein. But I always associate arms out in front with Frankenstein. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice job. Glute kicks or cardio of your choice coming up next. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Glute kicks or cardio, get your heart rate up. I am definitely sweating up a storm. Nice job. That's the end of the first round of secret. I keep wanting to say secret three. Circuit three. 3, 2, 1. Bicep curls to shoulder press. Palms face away from you. Fingertips point down. Bend those elbows. And then elbows swing wide. Palms face forward as you raise the roof. Beautiful. Bend up, out, push up. Bend back down. Shoulders stay stacked over hips. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up, standing glute kickbacks. Hold on to something for balance if you need. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Bring one heel to your bottom, then do a sharp push of your heel back behind you, keeping that bend in your knee. And then release, switch sides. So if any of you are familiar with donkey kicks, this is the standing version of Donkey Kick. Nice job. 3, 2, 1. Rest. Next up, front arm raises. 3, 2, 1. Exercise. Palms to your thighs. Raise those arms, zombie arms. Shoulders stay stacked over hips, belly button pulled to your spine. You're working your shoulders and your lats. Next job. Woohee! I feel alive. I was sleepy this morning. This definitely got me awake. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. We're resting. Next up is going to be our cardio, glute kicks, or cardio of your choice. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Glute kicks, or just get your heart rate up, however suits you best. Whew. Take nice deep breaths and just keep moving. This is the second time through circuit 3. We have one. Actually, we're just going to finish after this one so that I can get into some circuit 4 before we end. 3, 2, 1. Whee! Okay, reset. Take your break. I'll stop the music here. Circuit 4. I'm just going to get a quick drink. Circuit 4 is on the ground. So we're going to start with corkscrew. So lay on your back. I think almost everyone has done corkscrew and core stability. So I'll go through these quick. So last circuit is focused on abs. Lay on your back, hands pushed down into the ground on the outside of each of your hips. Belly button pulls to spine. Put both legs, squeeze them together, point them towards the ceiling. And then circle your legs, draw a circle with your toes. Once you finish that circle, reverse the directions. That's working your lower abs right beneath your belly button. Any questions about corkscrew? Okay. Next up is obliques. We're gonna do dead bug. So you can start with your, let's start with our knees bent. So we're on our back still, knees are bent to 90 degrees, shins parallel with the ceiling, knees are right over hips, like an upside down tabletop, if you will. Arms to the ceiling. Then you'll extend your right leg long to lower to the ground. As you extend your left leg or left arm back behind you, lower to the ground. Then you come back up, repeat, switch sides. If extending your leg long puts a strain on your lower back, you can just tap that foot down to the ground and lift it up, keeping the bend in your knee. That's working obliques as we move one side of our body and not the other. Any questions about dead bug? Okay. Then we go to strengthening our back with bird dog. So we get into a true tabletop on our hands and knees, hands underneath shoulders, knees underneath hips. Left leg extends long behind us, right arm reaches forward. Lots of balance going here. Come back down, switch sides. Back is so flat that nothing could spill off of it. I think I'm making like a sweet potato black bean soup today. So that's what's on my back. No soup spilling off your back. That is bird dog. Any questions about bird dog? Okay. Then last exercises for upper abs. So we're going to get onto our backs, feet flat on the floor, knees point towards the ceiling. You're going to do a crunch. So lift your shoulder blades off the ground. And then I want you to hold your shoulder blades off the ground and lift your arms up to the ceiling. And then lower your arms back behind your head and lift them back up, trying to keep your shoulder blades off the ground. So it's a crunch with an arm raise and lower. If that is a lot of strain on your abs so that you start feeling it in your neck, just put your hands behind your head, elbows wide, go into a standard crunch. Any questions about circuit 4? Okay. I'm going to try to get a couple of circuits in here for circuit 4. So we start on the ground. I'll start our timer. Start our tunes. Starting on your back with corkscrew. In three, two, one. Here we go. Head is rested, back is flat. Legs glued, pointed towards the ceiling. Circle in one direction. Once you get to the end of your circle, reverse your direction. If your lower back starts to peel off the ground, make your circle a little bit higher towards the ceiling. Make your circle a little bit smaller. If your back is glued to the ground, lower your legs to a diagonal a bit. Make the circles a little bit bigger. Three, two, one, rest. Next up, dead bug. So stay where you are. Knees are bent, shins to the ceiling, arms up to the sky. Three, two, one, exercise. Opposite leg and opposite arm reach away from the body and then bring it back, repeat. Alternating sides. Option to tap your toe on the ground, keeping the bend in your knee instead of extending it long. It's a little less pressure on the low back here. Back stays glued to the ground. We are working obliques, but we are also working lower abs here. Three, two, one. Rest. Next up, bird dog, tabletop position. Three, two, one. Exercise. Opposite arm and opposite leg reach long. Option to do one limb at a time. So one arm reaches, the other arm reaches, one leg reaches, the other leg reaches. If that helps you keep your back nice and flat. Nice job. Breathe through it. Three, two, one. Rest. Next up, upper abs. So that's the upper crunch with a hold and the arm raise and lower. Three, two, one. Exercise. So crunch up, arms to the ceiling, arms reach back behind you, trying to keep your shoulder blades nice and high. If your neck starts to hurt, hands behind head, elbows wide, standard crunch. Deep breaths. Each time your arms reach back, creates an additional challenge through your upper abs. Three, two, one, rest. We'll go through that set one more time. Let's do corkscrew. Back is flat, head is rested. Three, two, one, exercise. Legs glued together, up to the ceiling, draw circles with your toes. Legs in one long line. Reverse the directions of your circle each time you go through. Back is glued to the ground. Nice job, everybody. Last time doing these corkscrews. Three, two, one. Rest. Nice job. Next up, we go into our dead bugs. So you stay here, bend your knees, shins towards the ceiling, arms up. Three, two, one. Here we go. Opposite arm, opposite leg, reach away from the body, then come back to your starting position. Obliques and lower abs. Feel your side abs fatigue as you reach away and come back in. Nice deep breaths. Three, two, one. Rest. Next up, our bird dogs, strengthening the back side of our core in tabletop position. Three, two, one, exercise. Opposite hand, opposite arm, reach away from the torso. Very similar movement. It's like a dead bug and a true tabletop here. Working the back side of the core. Belly button is still pulled into spine. Keep your back nice and flat. No, it's butternut squash. That's what it is. Butternut squash and black bean soup. I'm making it for the first time. I'll tell you how it goes. Three, two, one. Rest. And upper abs. Lay on your backs. Three, two, one. Exercise. Shoulder blades up high. Reach your arms back. Reach your arms up. Can you guys tell that I have trouble focusing on one task at a time? Thinking about my dinner. job. Breathe through it. Last exercise before we cool down. Three, two, one, rest. Beautiful. Nice job, everybody. I'll stop those tunes and turn on some calm tunes. Yay. Okay, I can't hear them, but hopefully you can. Okay, let's go to tabletop position. For our cool down, as always, feel free to do exercises that or stretches that suit your body best or follow along with me. From your tabletop position, dip your belly low, point your nose forward for cow. Nice stretch through those abdominals that we just worked so hard. This is so good, feels so good. And then when you're ready, push through your palms, arch your back to the sky, tuck your chin to your chest, stretching out the muscles all around your spine. Go ahead, switch through these at your own pace. You guys, nobody told me to turn on my fan.
I think the word is hurt so good, not feel so good, Tara. At least that beginning part.
Yeah, I really put in the work today alongside all of you guys.
It makes me feel like I've accomplished something, though, when I get that lactic acid buildup. So
yes.
Thank you for that.
Oh, you're great. Welcome.
I agree.
Okay. Go ahead. Trisha, you and your inchworms, you and I are going to have words. Yeah,
muted.
We're
going to
have
she
words
can't.
The next time you do ball yoga.
Okay, let's go lay on our back, tug our right knee to our chest. You can extend your left leg long or rest your left foot flat on the floor. Honestly, I'm a fan of, so like the tricep push-ups are so hard, like I think they're so hard, but I do them, and like the inchworms are hard, I do them because we all like make each other do them. So I'm like, well, at least I'll have other people to work through it with me. Gives me the motivation I need.
Well, if it's hard to do it, that just tells you that's what you need to work on. The easy stuff
exactly.
Isn't what we need to work on.
Exactly. Go ahead.
Okay, lunges after wall sits are shaky at best.
You're welcome. Mine was.
Yeah. I'm like, oh my gosh, my legs are quivering.
Me too.
Yeah, Tara, you got me sweating, I'll tell you.
Good. All right, when you're ready, I don't know if I said to switch, but if you didn't switch legs, feel free to switch. I'm going to go ahead and go into my seated forward fold. Yeah, when I make these, so I basically break down all of the different like major muscle groups, and then I do different exercises to make sure that it's a full body workout. But when I went into circuit two, I really just loaded that one up, didn't I? At least it's circuit two.
I like a piece of cake compared to circuit two. Which
right.
is, I suppose, gotta recover somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The wall sit, because you're stationary.
Right.
Yeah, right. Okay.
I'm just teasing.
You know, I'm glad you made that circuit too, because that's the least likely circuit to ever shorten.
Yeah, that's true.
You never run out of time for circuit two.
I'm in butterfly pose now. That's right, because it's the first two, so we got to work for it. Yeah, in one of my workout classes, one of the instructors said, okay, like we were doing a version of wall sits or chair pose or something. And she was like, all right, yeah, just sit back, relax. And I was like, is this how you relax? This is not how I relax.
Yeah.
No.
All right, I'm going to stop our recording.